Unit 6 Input and Output File System. So first we will see what is file. File means the data collection which is created by the users. And the file system is one set of the most important part of the operating system to user. So desirable properties of files, that is long-term existence. There are three properties: long-term existence, shareable between process and structure. Long-term existence means files are stored on a disk or other secondary storage and do not disappear when users logs off. Then shareable between processes. The files have the names and can have associated access permission that permit colored sharing. And the third property of file is structure. So file can be organized into hierarchical or more complex structure to reflect the relationship among files. Then the next is file system. So it provides a means to store a data organized as files as well as collection of functions that can be performed on file. It maintains a set of attributes associated with the file. The typical operation of the file system consists of create, delete, open, close, read and write. So the four terms are commonly used when discussing the file: the field, record, file and database. Then the structure terms. The field, first term is field. It is a basic element of the data. It contains a single value. It has a fixed or variable length. Then the second is file. Second term is file. File is the collection of similar records which is treated as a single entity. It may be referenced by a name. Access control restrictions usually apply at the file level. Then the third term is database. It is a collection of related data. Relationship among elements of the data are explicit. It is designed for the use by a number of different applications. It consists of one or more types of the file. And the third term is record. It is a collection of related field that can be treated as a unit by some application program. It has a fixed or variable length. So the structure term consists of these four terms: field, file, database and record. So first is the file management system. Next is the file management system objective. So here meet the data management needs of the user. It guarantee that the data in the file are valid. Optimize the performance. It provide an input-output support for variety of storage device types. Also, it minimizes the potential for the lost or destroyed data. It provide a standardized set of the input-output interface routine to user process. Also, it provide input-output support for multiple user in the case of multi-user system. So these are the objectives for file management system. Next is device drivers. Device driver is the lowest level. It communicates directly with the peripheral devices and it is responsible for starting input-output operation on a device. The process is the completion of an input-output device and considered to be a part of the operating system. Basic file system. It is also referred to the physical input-output level. Basic file system is physical input-output level. The primary interface with the convenient outside the computer system. It deals with the blocks of the data that are exchanged with the disk or the tape system. It is concerned with the placement of the blocks and the secondary storage device. And it is concerned with the buffering block in the main memory. Consider the part of the operating system. So this is a basic file system. Next is basic input-output supervisor. So it is responsible for all file input-output initiation and termination. Control the structure that deal with the device input-output scheduling and file status are maintained. It selects the device on which the input-output is to be performed. It is concerned with the scheduling disk and tape access to optimize the performance. The input-output buffers are assigned and secondary memory is allocated at this level. So it is a part of operating system. Next is logical input-output. It enables users and applications to access the record. It provides a general purpose record input-output capability and maintain the basic data about the file. closest method, the label of the file system closest to the user. It provides a standard interface between the application and the file system and the devices that hold the data. Then the different access method reflect the different file structure and different ways of accessing and processing the data. So this is related to the access method. This diagram shows the elements of the file management, that is file management concerns and the operating system concerns. The file management concern consists of user and program command, and the operating file operations, file name, which is given to the file structure, and then access method, file manipulation function. Operating system concerns, it consists of a blocking, physical block and main memory buffer, physical blocking, secondary storage, disk. Then the file organization and access. Now what is file organization? File organization means it is a logical structuring of the record as determined by the way in which they are accessed. So in choosing a file organization, the several criteria are important, that is short access time, ease of update, economy of storage, simple maintenance, reliability, and the priority of the criteria depends on the application that will use the file. File organization is the logical structuring of the record as determined by the way in which they are accessed. Next is the file organization types. There, it has a five of the common file organizations are the indexed file, direct or the hashed file, the pipe, the sequential file, and the indexed sequential file. So here diagram is shown for the file sequential file, index sequential file, and the indexed file. Next, operations performed on a directory. So to understand the requirement for the file structure, it is helpful to consider the types of the operation that may be performed on a directory, that is search, create file, delete file, list directory, update directory. These are the operations performed in the directory. Next is two-level scheme. So there is a one directory for each user and a master directory. The master directory has an entry for each user directory providing address and access control information. Each user directory is a simple list of the files of that user. The names must be unique only within the collection of the file of a single user. The file system can easily enforce access restrictions on the directory. So file system can easily enforce access relations in the directory. Next is the file sharing. There are two issues arise when allowing files to be shared among a number of users. One is the access right and second is the management of the simultaneous access. So what is access right? In access right, the first point is name. So the user would not be allowed to read the user directory that includes the file. Next, knowledge. The user can determine that the file exists and who its owner is, and it can then petition the owner for additional access right. Next, execution. The user can load and execute a program but cannot copy it. Next, reading. The user can read the file for any purpose including copying and execution. Next, appending. The user can add a data to the file but it cannot modify or delete any of the file's content. Next, updating. The user can modify, delete and add to the file's data. Next, changing protection. The user can change the access right granted to other users. Next, deletion. The user can delete the file from the file system. So these are all the points related to access rights. also record blocking. So the blocks are the units of input-output with secondary storage. For input-output to be performed, records must be organized as a blocks. Given the size of the block, three methods of blocking can be used. One is fixed length blocking, second variable length, and third variable length unspanned. So fixed length blocking means fixed length records are used and an integral number of records are stored in a block. Internal fragmentation is unused space at the end of the each block. The variable length span blocking. Variable length records are used and are packed into the block with no unused space. Variable length unspanned blocking. Variable length records are used but spanning is not employed in unspanned blocking. So this is all about the record blocking, which has three types. So this diagram shows the record blocking methods, that is the fixed blocking, variable blocking, span and variable blocking and span. This diagram is for the record blocking methods. Next is the file allocation. So on the secondary storage, a file consists of collection of blocks. The operating system or the file management system is responsible for allocating the blocks to files. The approach taken for the file allocation may influence the approach taken for free space management. What is space is allocated to a file as one or more portions contiguous set of the allocated blocks. So file allocation table, that is FAT, it is a data structure which is used to keep the track of the portions assigned to a file. Next is pre-allocation versus dynamic allocation. So pre-allocation policy require that the maximum size of the file be declared at the time of file creation request. For many applications, it is difficult to estimate reliably the maximum potential size of the file, and it tends to be wasteful because users and application programs tend to overestimate size. The dynamic allocation allocates the space to a file in position on portions as needed. Next, portion size. In choosing a portion size, there is a trade-off between efficiency from the point of view of a single file versus overall system efficiency. So items to be considered. First is contiguity of the space increases the performance, especially for retry next operation, and it is greatly for the transactions running in transaction oriented operating system. It is having a large number of small portions increases the size of the table needed to manage the allocation information. Third one, having a fixed size portion simplifies the reallocations of space. And fourth one, having a variable size or a small fixed size portion minimizes a waste of unused storage due to over allocation. There are two major alternatives, variable large contiguous portion and second is blocks. So variable large contiguous operation, it provides a better performance. The variable size avoid the waste and the file allocation tables are small. In block, it has a small fixed portion provide a greater flexibility. They may require a large table or complex structure for their allocation, and contiguity has been abandoned as a primary goal and the blocks are allocated as needed. This table shows the file allocation methods, contiguous chain and index for the different parameters, that is pre-allocation, fixed or variable, size, portion size, allocation frequency, time to allocate, file allocation, table size. So for contiguous, the pre-allocation is necessary. For chain and index, it is possible. For contiguous, the fixed or variable size portion, the portion size is variable. For chain, it is fixed. For indexed, it can be fixed or variable. Then portion size for contiguous is large and small for chain and indexed, and also medium for index. Allocation frequency once for contiguous, low to high chain, and for indexed, it is high and low. Time to allocate, it is medium for contiguous, then for chain it is long, for indexed it is short and medium. File allocation table size, one entry for contiguous and chain, for indexed it is large and medium. Now this diagram shows the contiguous file allocation. Here file name ABCDE is given and the start block and its length is also given. Then the next is contiguous file allocation after compaction. So file name, start block and length is given. Next is chain allocation is also given. Next diagram shows the chain allocation after consolidation. So for the diagram for this is shown here. Next is indexed allocation with block portion. And next diagram shows the indexed allocation with variable length portion. So for contiguous, the five file names is given, that is file A, B, C, D, which is shown in the diagram. Then start block for the file A is 2. So from 2 it is started. For file B, start block is 9, which is shown in the gray color. For block for file C, the starting block is 18, so the line blocks are shown here. For file D, the starting block is 30. So for file block, it is shown by the cross lines. And for file E, 26 is the start block. So in this chain allocation after consolidation, this is normal before. So it is 5B, starting block is 1 and the length is 5. This shows the indexed allocation with block portion. So here 5B is given and the index block is 24. Next is the free space management. So just as allocated space must be managed, so must the unallocated space. To perform the file allocation, it is necessary to know which blocks are available. So disk allocation table is needed in addition to a file allocation table. So this is free space management. Thank you.